Like the giant sea monsters that once stalked the ocean floors, an unlikely creature still roams the earth. So much like the treasured whales of the seas, elephants are the precious last remnants of the largest land animals in the world. Even a gigantic bull will play away the day, wallowing in the coolness of a life that ambles along at its own pace. A life as long as our own, but with so much more time. Time to be simply what they are. But this sense of calm and meditation can be deceptive. For a whole year, one small herd races against time and the drying water holes. Often, the battle over the precious water enrages them. Two tiny calves are caught up in this struggle, coaxed through their early years that are fraught with dangers. As large as they are, elephants are sensitive and gentle creatures. Haunting discoveries of burial rituals, language, and understanding suggest intelligence and even emotions. These are the last of a dying race. Watching them, we can reflect not only on their complex behavior, but on our own as well. Join us for a few moments and reflections on elephants. Africa seldom relaxes. It always seems to be waiting for the gentler moments to pass. Around rainwater pools strewn across the dry country of Botswana, doves and sand grouse stir up the air in a frenzy to drink before the soft edges of the day burn off. Elephants are a symbol of the African wilderness, woven into its fabric like the blazing skies and the endless savannas. In the midst of a swirling dance of smaller creatures, huge males live separate lives, usually ignoring any passing herds of females and calves. Around these scattered water holes, they live out their isolation, slowly drawing life from the earth's open wounds. With a lifespan of 60 years or longer, elephants pursue the rhythms of life at a leisurely but determined pace. Each movement is a calculated conservation of energy, each day a tiny investment in a legend. In the crisp morning, a herd of females and calves pads in silently from the forest. It is unusual for females like these to wander into the bull area, but they are anxious. It's been an eventful night. A calf was born to the matriarch, the leader of this herd. first day, danger is everywhere. The youngster is a female, and she will be guided carefully through life by her mother and the other family members. Because elephant societies are led by females, and her mother is a matriarch, it is likely that one day she too will have to carry on that tradition of leadership. But for now, she seems blissfully unaware of the dangers of life, more concerned with keeping close to her mother and balancing on her one-day-old legs. For this young calf, lions will be a recurring threat to her life. Towering giants block the way, but the determined opportunist is reluctant to go. When the calf flounders in the unfamiliar muddy water, she panics. But at this age, help is seldom far away. They bunch together, protecting her within a wall of legs and trunks. Even the females have tusks that lions must avoid. Safe against the bank, the little female has to contend with another new challenge, the first bowel movement, an unbalancing and alarming experience. With the lions still menacing, the matriarch must soon move her calf out of the waterhole. With her front toenails, she breaks away the edges, making a ramp for the short strides of the baby. As she leads her family through the gauntlet of lions, the matriarch's blood-stained legs are a testament to a stressful night and a new beginning, the start of a long journey. This journey takes place in southern Africa. Once, elephants roamed over most of this continent. They still wander freely over all their ancestral range in Botswana, one of the last havens for wild elephants. These seasonal movements of following the water cover over 40,000 square miles. The matriarch is guiding her herd along a network of ancient paths. She has decided to visit an old site to supplement the diet of the herd. They dig open the holes and turn the soil into fine white powder. Locked inside the dust are sodium and other valuable minerals that have leached into these soils. These mineral digs are investigated, remembered, and used. A rudimentary form of self-medication. It's not long before she gives the command to move on. As they glide along, they communicate gently in rumbles of very low frequencies. These sounds, almost silent to us, drift over the herd, just vibrations floating in the dust. Ahead, at the next waterhole, a tragic drama is unfolding. Another calf has been abandoned in the first few days of its life. Sometimes, sick or old females struggling to survive do leave infant calves to fend for themselves. Innocent to the virtues of silence in the dark, the young elephant calls out to the shadows. The cry is answered. But the hyena is nervous, wary of the approaching elephants. When the matriarch leads her herd into the water, they are drawn to the disturbance. But with the long journey ahead, this abandoned calf could be a grave burden to the whole herd. And he is rejected. The calls are too chilling, and the herd returns. The calf is caught up in the swirl of running legs and swept off into the dark. Adoption is rare in most species, but by daybreak, the rescued calf is part of the herd. Now, however, he has even greater challenges to deal with. It's an adoption, but by some strange twist of fate, his new mother is the matriarch, who already has her own newborn daughter. He is immediately seen as a competitor for the rich flavored milk. Elephants rarely have two calves at a time, so usually there is no competition for milk. Whether the matriarch adopted the calf, or the calf found the only lactating female in the herd, is hard to tell. But his rescue is no less than remarkable. Now he faces a new threat, starvation by sibling rivalry. Probing and testing like serpents coaxed out by a charmer's flute, sensitive trunks dance for a hidden delicacy. In Each shake is followed by a moment's silence. Not in reverence, but to listen for the seed pods falling. These pods are harvested annually. The trees are seldom damaged, unlike the robust mapani trees that they smash down to get to the nutritious upper leaves. A little bark from certain acacias yields fatty acids and minerals. It is thought that the fiber in the bark has medicinal uses for elephants as it does for humans. Herds all over northern Botswana are on the move now, traversing the corridors of their memories. Ancient trails that run like long veins of light, spreading out, then converging on the scattered waterholes. The most vulnerable are the very young. By the age of three, fewer than half the calves survive. Some lions specialize in outmaneuvering the herds, waging a constant war of nerves. Sometimes older calves become isolated, separated because their mothers have new young to look after. These newborn can be snatched up easily and must be well guarded. Often the older calves must fend for themselves. As harsh as it may seem, it is necessary. With animals that live so long, some deaths are important to regulate the population. Only in paradise is death banned from claiming the weak. At the waterhole, a lone male suddenly feels the awakenings in his body. It is the time of his must. Like the new dawn, this feeling is fresh and vital. He can take on anything. Must comes to males once a year, but only begins halfway through their lives. This is their breeding phase, when high levels of testosterone turn their thoughts to conquest. Another bull has the same feelings of elation today and is also ready to confront the world. When a breeding herd of females glides towards the combatants, the silence is deceptive. This victorious bull has already heard the low rumbles from an eager female across the plain. As he draws nearer, she coyly breaks away. And the chase is on. He hunts her down. She knows she is being hunted, and with a smaller body weight, She could easily outrun him as she has lesser suitors this week. But this time she is willing and stops. Elephant mating takes a lot of cooperation. This coordinated sexual readiness of both male and female is quite unique in animals, and for several days they will stay together. By soliciting this must bull, she has purposely chosen her mate and wins as a prize his dominant genes for her offspring. Her calf will be born nearly 2 years from now. Waves of thirsty giants stampede the water holes. Anything in the way is chased off. But before rushing in, they stop and test the air. Each family, under the leadership of their matriarch, maintains long-distance contact with other groups. As the groups meet at the water holes, they melt together to become one clan again. Here, they congregate and reinforce bonds. Even after short separations, greetings are very active and affectionate. Screams of tension drive out non-clan members. Elephants tend to avoid strangers. But the large water holes attract herds from all around, both wanderers and regulars on this route. All mass together, but maintain their discrete groups around the water hole, hundreds or sometimes even thousands at a time. These gentle animals appear to want to avoid stressful encounters. With language skills of at least 25 different concepts, a complex stacking system is at work at these water holes. When incoming herds signal, the herd that was drinking vacates the water. In all this activity, the matriarch has arrived. Over the last 2 months, the adopted smaller calf seems to have worked out a way to survive. Water is still an unfamiliar experience for both calves. The adopted calf, possibly with less pleasant associations, is even more reluctant to venture in, despite the gentle coaxing. Others are here for the water as well. As hundreds of buffalo crowd in, stress rumbles through the elephant herds like an electric storm. Boxed in by the huge herd of buffalo, the matriarch and her family are forced to use the steep side of the bank. An older calf is jostled into the water. With the buffalo still threatening, a quick rescue is mounted. Displaying an intelligence of communication and astounding logic, the elephants divide their efforts. Some fend off the buffalo, while others tend to the frantic calf. Just a gentle stabilizer is needed, and a well-placed trunk does the job. And still, the matriarch doesn't lead them away. They need water before attempting the long journey ahead. In their eagerness to drink, the smaller adopted calf is shoved over the edge and into the mud. Now the danger of a buffalo stampede is even greater than before. The thick mud sucks at the calf's back legs. Following the matriarch's lead, they all climb into the mud to help. Desperate attempts to break down the bank only make the problem worse. The two females combine efforts, using tusks and trunks like shovels to keep the calf from drowning, while another digs a ramp. Together, the two females squeeze and push at the calf. The suction underneath is suddenly released, and the calf is free, at last. They tenderly reassure and smell the youngster, rescued for the second time in his life. The concerned herd now bunches against the converging buffalo. Outrage runs like wildfire among the herds, sparking explosions of aggression. But the buffalo keep pouring out of the forest, and dust hangs like smoke on a battlefield. The contest is finally resolved, and as the dust settles, the buffalo disperse. Somewhere in the confusion, a young buffalo was struck heavily in the head and side. The calf is doomed, injured beyond hope. The two calves move off with the herd, having avoided a muddy death themselves. The young buffalo's broken body is left behind. It causes some concern to the departing elephants, suggesting an awareness of injury and death, even of other species. Like huge cathedrals or ancient monoliths, the solid shapes block out the sun. A long way from the congregating female herds, the bulls gently sway to a rhythmic dance of the giants, a shuffle of constant adjustment in a display of dominance and submission. Each one of these bulls has a rank. Each responds to the next one. Every newcomer to the gathering provokes a reaction that flashes through the memories of all the contestants. Anyone unsure of his status soon learns the rules of this tournament of giants. Status is determined by body size or age. Tusks have little to do with it. The contest is for water, as usual. In a classic bull area like Savuti, up to 200 elephants compete for this one resource. In this melee, they must constantly be aware of who is around. A sensitive tail is an advantage. With their heads used like huge medieval maces, bodies jostle and tusks joust for the precious liquid. This struggle may seem like a chaotic free-for-all, but with each changing combination, the field plan of the hierarchy is reset in a surprisingly orderly fashion. One ghostly form is excluded from the commotion. His gaunt features and sagging skin are sure signs of his age and fading energy for life. With his last set of grinding teeth nearly worn away, his days are numbered. Too weak to join in, he can only watch the competing bulls and wait. By dusk, his body cries out for the moisture leached from it by the heat. He can no longer resist, and with fewer bulls around the water, he makes his move. Drawing himself up to his full height, he forces himself into the circle. At last, he drinks. districts. When a mud-covered dominant bull returns, the ghostly elephant should retreat. But the water still beckons him. It is a mistake. A jagged tusk slices through the old skin into his neck. The old bull goes down with barely a struggle, losing blood fast. Even before the old bull dies, a young male carries out a bizarre mock-mating display. This behavior can only be explained as an attempt to upgrade his own status with this show of domination. The old bull dies quickly and silently in the night, though his fate was long since determined. Companions defend the carcass against the hyenas, a useless endeavor. His body must continue its usefulness to Africa, even after his death. Like an ancient burial ritual, attention is paid to every detail. Understand this behavior. Is it a macabre fascination with the dead, or perhaps a tribute to a fallen companion? And why is the ivory so often the focus of these haunting examinations? As a week passes, the carcass gradually relinquishes its form. There is no mythological elephant graveyard, no common place where bones and tusks are taken, just the eventual scatterings in the dust. As the last scavengers squabble over the scraps of the body, a few bulls remain, perhaps still nurturing a special bond with the old elephant. Before we could really understand his ways and the ways of his species, the bull's spirit floats away. 8 days, and what was once a giant of the world is no more than just a memory. Just a reflection of a time when elephants roamed Africa from sea to sea and ruled the continent. Once again, the clans are gathering, marching for the rivers. Paths interlace, leaving behind a swath of flattened vegetation. This This constant ebb and flow of bodies affects some areas while resting others, a balance that is forever changing. The females head for the best feeding and good water, not only for the living, but for their unborn as well. The final miles are covered on the run toward the rivers. Here, the matriarch and her calves will see out the next 3 months of the dry season. Even in this chaotic climber for water, the elephants show a sensitivity and awareness of who is around them and where their other clan families are. After a grueling 6 months, the calves, possibly sensing that their constant march is over, take on a new playfulness and relax. But now, when the oppressive heat stings their dark bodies, they can hide from its burning fingers. Gradually, the elephants drop down like weary puppets at the end of a show, both young and old drifting into a rare sleepiness. For them, there are easy ways to shut out the world. They seldom allow themselves to sleep for long. Just a few minutes at a time are needed by animals with such long, slow lives. Only when they are all up and ready will the matriarch lead them out of the shade, always keeping the herd together. But sometimes things go wrong. Occasionally, calves are left behind and wander around lost, testing each herd they approach. When he sees the matriarch and goes to greet the herd, this young male is turned away. His best chance of being found is to keep searching. Despite their good communication, these separations are inevitable. Newborn calves have begun to displace the older ones. Unbeknown to him, his real family is across the plain, heading into the forest. Suddenly, he finds himself among lions. Before he can turn, the juvenile is locked in a deadly game. But this time, innocence is matched by inexperience. The lions are young and seem more intent on experimenting than killing. Lions often prey on the weak, but this calf is lost, not ailing. A determined opponent with a thick hide, not easy to penetrate. But soon he tires. And the lions close in for the kill. Quite suddenly, the experiment is over. The lions are exhausted and lose interest. The calf responds, surprising the lions with his new zest for life. As they watch, he slips away. What emotions elephants feel during these struggles, we do not know. That they do feel something is quite apparent. Back in the bull area, when old bones have all but turned to dust, the mud relinquishes a precious last reminder of the old bull at the waterhole. Like a trophy, it is carried into the open, displayed and fondled. Like a memory, it is tasted and nurtured. This haunting behavior is difficult to understand. How can we ever know what elephants feel and what form these emotions take? A mystery forever. When they attempt to destroy ivory by smashing it against rocks or try to crush tusks by standing on them, are they displaying a new behavior, a solemn response to the atrocities of our time? Or is this an ancient ritual? And if so, what does it mean? At the river, the matriarch leads her herd on a final push for better feeding on the north bank. Swimming is little problem for elephants. They share an ancestry with sea-going mammals like dugongs and manatees. Large vacant nasal and sinus cavities keep their heavy heads afloat, and their fat makes them buoyant. On the south bank, a timid young bull refuses to swim and watches the herd disappear. By now, the young bull has given up all attempts at swimming. The herd's ancient knowledge has betrayed them this time. But when they finally emerge on the north bank, they have crossed into another country, Namibia. The stranded young bull still calls to them in alarm. The herd is now fair game for hunters, poachers, and traders. And a wave of communication flashes back and forth across the river. Then, reacting as one, they plunge into the water to swim back to the young bull. Although by now the exhausted young calves are at risk of drowning in the strong current, a fatal conflict with man has been avoided. On the south bank, greetings and urgent reassurances flood from the herd, but he will not be persuaded. The herd gives up and remains on the familiar and safer soils of Botswana, the end of the restless journey for the matriarch and her calves. For this year. This may be the last generation of elephants to traverse these ancestral ranges, the last truly free elephants. As we succeed more and more as a species, they seem to slip further and further from our reach. It has been said that we could do worse than mold our own lives on those of elephants. Lives filled with dignity and gentle bearing and time. Perhaps we need more time to understand those gentle celebrations of life and death that are like silent whispers in the moonlight. More time for reflections on elephants. Perhaps the calls are too chilling, and the herd returns. The calf is caught up in the swirl of running legs and swept off into the dark. Adoption is rare in most species, but by daybreak, the rescued calf is part of the herd. Now, however, he has even greater challenges to deal with. It's an adoption, But by some strange twist of fate, his new mother is the matriarch, who already has her own newborn daughter. He is immediately seen as a competitor for the rich-flavored milk. Elephants rarely have two calves at a time, so usually there is no competition for milk. Whether the matriarch adopted the calf, or the calf found the only lactating female in the herd, is hard to tell. But his rescue is no less than remarkable. Now he faces a new threat: starvation by sibling rivalry. Probing and testing like serpents coaxed out by a charmer's flute, sensitive trunks dance for a hidden delicacy. Each shake is followed by a moment's silence. Not in reverence, but to listen for the seed pods falling. By now, the young bull has given up all attempts at swimming. The herd's ancient knowledge has betrayed them this time. But when they finally emerge on the north bank, they have crossed into another country, Namibia. The stranded young bull still calls to them in alarm. The herd is now fair game for hunters, poachers, and traders. And a wave of communication flashes back and forth across the river. Then, reacting as one, they plunge into the water to swim back to the young bull. Although by now the exhausted young calves are at risk of drowning in the strong current, a fatal conflict with man has been avoided. On the south bank, greetings and urgent reassurances flood from the herd, but he will not be persuaded. The herd gives up and remains on the familiar and safer soils of Botswana, the end of the restless journey for the matriarch and her calves. For this year. This may be the last generation of elephants to traverse these ancestral ranges, the last truly free elephants. As we succeed more and more as a species, they seem to slip further and further from our reach. It has been said that we could do worse than mold our own lives on those of elephants. Lives filled with dignity and gentle bearing and time. Perhaps we need more time to understand those gentle celebrations of life and death that are like silent whispers in the moonlight. More time for reflections on elephants. As the dust settles, the buffalo disperse. Somewhere in the confusion, a young buffalo was struck heavily in the head and side. The calf is doomed, injured beyond hope. The two calves move off with the herd, having avoided a muddy death themselves. The young buffalo's broken body is left behind. It causes some concern to the departing elephants, suggesting an awareness of injury and death, even of other species. Like huge cathedrals or ancient monoliths, the solid shapes block out the sun. A long way from the congregating female herds, the bulls gently sway to a rhythmic dance of the giants, a shuffle of constant adjustment in a display of dominance and submission. Each one of these bulls has a rank. Each responds to the next one. Every newcomer to the gathering provokes a reaction that flashes through the memories of all the contestants. Anyone unsure of his status soon learns the rules of this tournament of giants. Status is determined by body size or age. Tusks have little to do with it. The contest is for water, as usual. In a classic bull area like Savuti, up to 200 elephants compete for this one resource. In this melee, they must constantly be aware of who is around. As the last scavengers squabble over the scraps of the body, a few bulls remain, perhaps still nurturing a special bond with the old elephant. Before we could really understand his ways and the ways of his species, the bull's spirit floats away. 8 days, and what was once a giant of the world is no more than just a memory. Just a reflection of a time when elephants roamed Africa from sea to sea and ruled the continent. Once again, the clans are gathering, marching for the rivers. Paths interlace, leaving behind a swath of flattened vegetation. This constant ebb and flow of bodies affects some areas while resting others. A balance that is forever changing. The females head for the best feeding and good water, not only for the living, but for their unborn as well. Final miles are covered on the run toward the rivers. Here, the matriarch and her calves will see out the next 3 months of the dry season. Even in this chaotic clamor for water, the elephants show a sensitivity and awareness of who is around them and where their other clan families are. As they glide along, they communicate gently in rumbles of very low frequencies. These sounds, almost silent to us, drift over the herd, just vibrations floating in the dust. Ahead, at the next waterhole, a tragic drama is unfolding. Another calf has been abandoned in the first few days of its life. Sometimes, sick or old females struggling to survive do leave infant calves to fend for themselves. Innocent to the virtues of silence in the dark, the young elephant calls out to the shadows. The cry is answered. But the hyena is nervous, wary of the approaching elephants. When the matriarch leads her herd into the water, they are drawn to the disturbance. But with the long journey ahead, this abandoned calf could be a grave burden to the whole herd. And he is rejected. The calls are too chilling, and the herd returns. The calf is caught up in the swirl of running legs and swept off into the dark. For this young calf, lions will be a recurring threat to her life. Towering giants block the way, but the determined opportunist is reluctant to go. When the calf flounders in the unfamiliar muddy water, she panics. But at this age, help is seldom far away. They bunch together, protecting her within a wall of legs and trunks. Even the females have tusks that lions must avoid. Safe against the bank, the little female has to contend with another new challenge, the first bowel movement, an unbalancing and alarming experience. With the lions still menacing, the matriarch must soon move her calf out of the waterhole. With her front toenails, she breaks away the edges, making a ramp for the short strides of the baby. As she leads her family through the gauntlet of lions, the matriarch's blood-stained legs are a testament to a stressful night and a new beginning, the start of a long journey. This journey takes place in southern Africa. Once, elephants roamed over most of this continent. They still wander freely over all their ancestral range in Botswana, one of the last havens for wild elephants. These seasonal movements of following the water cover over 40,000 square miles. With animals that live so long, some deaths are important to regulate the population. Only in paradise is death banned from claiming the weak. At the waterhole, a lone male suddenly feels the awakenings in his body. It is the time of his must. Like the new dawn, this feeling is fresh and vital. He can take on anything. Must comes to males once a year, but only begins halfway through their lives. This is their breeding phase, when high levels of testosterone turn their thoughts to conquest. Another bull has the same feelings of elation today and is also ready to confront the world. When a breeding herd of females glides towards the combatants, the silence is deceptive. This victorious bull has already heard the low rumbles from an eager female across the plain. As he draws nearer, she coyly breaks away. And the chase is on. He hunts her down. She knows she is being hunted, and with a smaller body weight, she could easily outrun him as she has lesser suitors this week. But this time she is willing and stops. Elephant mating takes a lot of cooperation. This coordinated sexual readiness of both male and female is quite unique in elephants are gathering, marching for the rivers. Paths interlace, leaving behind a swath of flattened vegetation. This constant ebb and flow of bodies affects some areas while resting others, a balance that is forever changing. The females head for the best feeding and good water, not only for the living, but for their unborn as well. Final miles are covered on the run toward the rivers. Here, the matriarch and her calves will see out the next 3 months of the dry season. Even in this chaotic clamor for water, the elephants show a sensitivity and awareness of who is around them and where their other clan families are. After a grueling 6 months, the calves, possibly sensing that their constant march is over, take on a new playfulness and relax. But now, when the oppressive heat stings their dark bodies, they can hide from its burning fingers. Gradually, the elephants drop down like weary puppets at the end of a show, both young and old drifting into a rare sleepiness. For them, there are easy ways. The final miles are covered on the run toward the rivers. Here, the matriarch and her calves will see out the next 3 months of the dry season. Even in this chaotic clamor for water, the elephants show a sensitivity and awareness of who is around them and where their other clan families are. After a grueling 6 months, the calves, possibly sensing that their constant march is over, take on a new playfulness and relax. Now, when the oppressive heat stings their dark bodies, they can hide from its burning fingers. Gradually, the elephants drop down like weary puppets at the end of a show, both young and old drifting into a rare sleepiness. For them, there are easy ways to shut out the world. They seldom allow themselves to sleep for long. Just a few minutes at a time are needed by animals with such long, slow lives. When they attempt to destroy ivory by smashing it against rocks or try to crush tusks by standing on them, are they displaying a new behavior, a solemn response to the atrocities of our time? Or is this an ancient ritual, And if so, what does it mean? At the river, the matriarch leads her herd on a final push for better feeding on the north bank. Swimming is little problem for elephants. They share an ancestry with sea-going mammals like dugongs and manatees. Large vacant nasal and sinus cavities keep their heavy heads afloat, and their fat makes them buoyant. On the south bank, a timid young bull refuses to swim and watches the herd disappear. By now, the young bull has given up all attempts at swimming. The herd's ancient knowledge has betrayed them this time. But when they finally emerge on the north bank, they have crossed into another country, Namibia. The stranded young bull still calls to them in alarm. The herd is now fair game for hunters, poachers, and traders. And the wave of communication flashes back and forth across the river. Then, reacting as one, they plunge into the water to swim back to the young bull. Females like these to wander into the bull area, but they are anxious. It's been an eventful night. A calf was born to the matriarch, the leader of this herd. From the first day, danger is everywhere. The youngster is a female, and she will be guided carefully through life by her mother and the other family members. Because elephant societies are led by females, and her mother is a matriarch, it is likely that one day she too will have to carry on that tradition of leadership. But for now, she seems blissfully unaware of the dangers of life. More concerned with keeping close to her mother and balancing on her one-day-old legs. For this young calf, lions will be a recurring threat to her life. Towering giants block the way, but the determined opportunist is reluctant to go. When the calf flounders in the unfamiliar muddy water, she panics. But at this age, help is seldom far away. They bunch together, protecting her within a wall of legs and trunks. Even the females have tusks that lions must avoid. Safe against the bank, the little female has to contend with another new challenge, the first bowel movement, an unbalancing and alarming experience. With the lion still menacing, the matriarch must soon move her calf out of the waterhole. With her front toenails, she breaks away the edges, making a ramp for the short strides of the baby. One ghostly form is excluded from the commotion. His gaunt features and sagging skin are sure signs of his age and fading energy for life. With his last set of grinding teeth nearly worn away, his days are numbered. Too weak to join in, he can only watch the competing bulls and wait. By dusk, his body cries out for the moisture leached from it by the heat. He can no longer resist, and with fewer bulls around the water, he makes his move. Drawing himself up to his full height, he forces himself into the circle. At last, he drinks. When a mud-covered dominant bull returns, the ghostly elephant should retreat, but the water still beckons him. It is a mistake. A jagged tusk slices through the old skin into his neck. The old bull goes down with barely a struggle, losing blood fast. Even before the old bull dies, a young male carries out a bizarre mock-mating display. This behavior can only be explained as an attempt to upgrade his own status with this show of domination. The old bull dies quickly and silently in the night, though his fate was long since determined. Companions defend the carcass against the hyenas, a useless endeavor. His body must continue its usefulness to Africa, even after his death.